more I read passages of the Bible, the more and more I say, boy, that one's my favorite one. And it's gotten to the point anymore that I basically might as well just say, this is my favorite book and go with that. But Titus chapter 2, that's where we're going to be today. That's where we've been going as we've been doing this daily reading. That's where we ended up today. And this is a very crucial passage. In fact, it applies very much so to our ministry here at Grace and our purpose as a body of Christ. I remember studying this class, or this book, excuse me, pretty extensively when I was in Greek class. We went through this word by word, and I don't know, honestly, if I'm honest, I don't know if I can recall all that information right now, but I do remember this particular context and this chapter's importance to the local church. Here at Grace, we have a vision, a mission, a purpose, and a message. And of course, our vision is what? To be a church of disciples, making disciples, reaching the world around us with the gospel of Christ, and commissioning disciples to the unreached world. Our mission is to love God and love others. Our purpose, wrapped up and fitting all in those things, what? To edify the saints. And part of what is also that we equip, that's another aspect of it, to equip one another. And that's really what Titus 2 gets at. Paul says this, and as he's writing to Titus, he says this, "But as for you, communicate the behavior that goes with sound teaching." He says, "Older men are to be temperate, dignified, self-controlled, sound in faith and love, and in endurance. Older women," then he says, "likewise, are to exhibit behavior fitting for those who are holy, not slandering, not slaves to excessive drinking, but teaching what is good. In this way, they," what? "Will train the younger women to love their husbands, to love their children, to be self-controlled, pure, fulfilling their duties at home, kind, being subject to their own husbands, so that the message of God may not be discredited. Encourage younger men likewise to be self-controlled." And then he speaks directly to Titus. He says, "showing yourself to be an example of good works in every way." You know, as we live our lives as believers, we are encouraged, what, to obedience. James says that in James chapter 1, 19 to 22, in that range in there, talking about us not just being merely hearers, but also doers of the word as well. And he says as well, what, that works really should be the fruit of our faith. And that we should be living, we shouldn't just trust in Jesus, but also what, live for Jesus at the same time, implementing the principles and commands that we find within the Word of God in our various contexts. And we do all of that on one aspect of just simply what, 1 Peter, of being holy as He is holy. God has set the standard, and He desires that we live in this way. But we also do it, what, to benefit the church body. We are iron sharpening iron. We are to spur one another on to love and good deeds. We are to equip one another day by day, that we might, what, also spiritually mature. And we do that how? As we are ourselves are examples to those around us of what it means, what, of younger men, of older men and their character qualities, young older women and their character, emulating those things before a younger generation, teaching them what it means to be godly men and women. And you know what? That involves some, not just living those things out, but maybe even doing things together where we have those purposeful opportunities to invest and to help young people implement these things in their lives. And I use young in a different way, you know, not just age. Yeah, that's part of it. But I think there's also an aspect of spiritual maturity as well. Sometimes younger individuals are very spiritually mature, perhaps in someone older than them, and they too can invest and help instill these godly qualities and characteristics in that person's life. Jesus, remember, as he is spending his time here on earth, he's living day in and day out with his disciples, teaching them what it means to do these various things as he was living them. And you know, really, that's the what we are to do as a church as well, is it not? To encourage and to help mature one another in our walks of faith. So this is an example here of what we are to be doing, what we're encouraged to do, Titus chapter 2. I challenge you, as you read through this text a few times today, maybe if and again before you go to bed tonight, and then ask yourself, how can I equip those around me? You know, and we can get pretty pretty creative in how we do that in our day and age. And we have a lot of things and means at our fingertips, but at first, what takes the step in doing it? Here's the encouragement. Let's think through it and ultimately purpose to take a step in that direction. Pray that that encourages and challenges you today. That's always the purpose of this time together, as that we might encourage and challenge one another to a deeper walk with Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Until next time, friends, God bless.